NFL, and today we have two teams who are more than ready to get the season underway. It's the Vikings going up against the Titans. With that, let's get you out to Nashville, where we welcome in our new team for 2016, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, Charles and I certainly looking forward to working with you this year.
Yes, we are.
Yes, indeed, as we welcome the rest of you in to Nissan Stadium here in Nashville, Tennessee. Today, the opener of the 2016 NFL season between the Minnesota Vikings and the Tennessee Titans. Charles, for the Vikings, 11-5 last year, tough loss in the wild card. Meanwhile, for Tennessee, they're just trying to forget that 3-13 year.
And Minnesota thinks that they've got a team that's built to go and win the Super Bowl. They figure after last year, with some new additions, they...
Throwing here on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. A gain of 6 there on first.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone.
Detroit!
And the first carry of the game here for Trey Mason. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. And they'll down to the 20. The rookie Mackenzie Alexander in there for the tackle.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
He lost 4 there, and it's third down. Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charlie.
First down.
It's a loss of 1 yard there, and now second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Goal line offense, something they've really been emphasizing in practice lately. Now they have a chance here to put all that hard work to use. And he will fight his way.
Oftentimes, after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
They'll set up to throw, and he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. The line of scrimmage is the 3 as they look to cash in on 3rd and goal.
All right, here we go.
They'll look to throw again. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown.
You got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
From the shotgun, it's Bradford. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Holding.
Hold on to this lead for dear life. Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. So, Charles, there are the numbers. What's happened here? Defensive adjustments that's caused him to sort of fall off a bit?
I think so. That has to happen. You've got to make some changes because in the first half, they were pretty effective. But the second part is sometimes when you're doing really well, you get off your game a little bit. You get off the gas a little bit. You're like, okay, we got this thing. And that's not necessarily the case. Maybe right now, someone just needs to tell a joke in the huddle, loosen things up, and get their big guy going again.
Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. A gain of six there on first. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Back to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They'll look to throw. Quick throw, that's complete on the inside slam. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. Down four late. Got to go for it here on fourth down.
Here we go now. Boom, land it.
They'll run for it with Mason. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 4 yards on the pickup, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And quickly, they get to the line. He's back to throw, and he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being very precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. They lost four there, and it's third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
Fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it was in the good old days, meaning you just drop to a point and react to the football. Now you end up with a lot of man-to-man principles once you get into your zone defense. In other words, get to your assignment and then locate a guy coming into your area, and then you end up covering him almost man-for-man. That allows him to make more plays on the football like the one we just saw there.
And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry-up. And this seemingly endless drive continues. Back to throw. A dump off for Mason. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside.
Green 39!
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. He's going to let it fly. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. It's the second round of Mackenzie Alexander. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
They will take the knee, and it means a great start to their 2016 campaign.